It's an iconic car from an iconic film, driven by an iconic actor. Let's meet the Rolls-Royce from the 1974 film, The Great Gatsby.
Robert Redford may have been the star of The Great Gatsby, but it's his car that painted the picture of opulence that author F. Scott Fitzgerald wanted his book to achieve.
So this is a 1928 Rolls-Royce Phantom 1 Ascot dual cowl sport phaeton. That is the full official title of this car, and that is a mouthful.
Daniel Folk is with Classic Promenade, the company responsible for selling this movie car in an online auction.
This car is built with a chassis and then the body mounted on top of it. This was very common practice, so much so that in this time, in the 1920s, 1930s, people would actually buy one chassis and multiple bodies. So for example, they might have a summer body and a winter body.
And long before it was in the movies, this Rolls was living a life of luxury.
The story with the original owner is in 1928, a woman in New York City ordered a vehicle, a Phantom 1. It was delivered to her address, which was at the Metropolitan Club. So no surprise, it was going to a well-to-do person. It was originally delivered with the chassis, but had a different body on it. The body that you see here is a 1931 Rolls-Royce. Sometime around 1945 or shortly thereafter, a 1931 Rolls Sport Phaeton suffered an engine fire, and the owner of this chassis decided that she wanted to have a different body on it. So they ended up doing a transplant, and the Gatsby Rolls that you see is a 1928 frame with a 1931 Sport Phaeton body.
But enough about its past. Let's talk about the Rolls movie debut.
So let's fast forward a little bit to 1973, 1974. The vehicle gets purchased by a big-time collector out of Massachusetts by the name of Ted Leonard. Ted Leonard acquires the car and within several months gets a call from Paramount Pictures asking him if he would be interested in using their car for a new movie they're filming called The Great Gatsby. Leonard agrees, and as part of the filming process, they end up doing just a quick and dirty paint job on the vehicle. It was never originally yellow, but it was in the book. So the car gets painted yellow very quickly. The leather seats are dyed green, and from 20 feet away and on, you know, through the lens of a camera, it looks fantastic. It's a huge part of that movie. F. Scott Fitzgerald in the book goes into great detail describing the intricacies of the vehicle, the chrome work, the dual windshields. It was, you know, it almost took on a character of its own. It was such a prominent figure in that story. So it goes into the movie. After filming is completed, you know, it's been on the cover of GQ magazine, Newsweek. It really took a life of its own after the film as well.
Today, that quick paint job is long gone. Replaced during a proper restoration that took 8 years. Work that restored both its beauty and drivability.
So driving a car like this really is a full body experience. You have to be completely engaged to operate all the mechanical levers and dials on this car. The stuff that you're seeing on the steering wheel operates the choke, fuel delivery, idle speed. And so it's this constant play of making sure the engine's running right, shifting the gears, working the clutch, steering this thing, it's really a fully engaging experience. It's also important to keep in mind that on camera, the Gatsby looks fantastic, but you can't really appreciate just how big this car is. It's almost as long as a Chevy Tahoe and weighs just as much. And so you're trying to shift gears and steer this thing, all of it's mechanical. It really is a physically demanding task.
True, but rewarding as well.
One of the things that amazes me most about cars of this vintage is just how smooth they are to drive. The way the engine's idle, you can you know, put a glass on it and it won't rattle, it won't shake off. They have a tremendous amount of stability at speeds that you might not think they can go. This vehicle, for example, will easily do 60, 70 miles an hour, and it can do it all day.
Robert Redford may have aged a little, but his co-star, this icon of automotive luxury, rolls on more elegant than ever.
As Jay Gatsby's fate proves, you can't repeat the past. But if you have the winning bid, you can at least drive it. Stay driven, old sport.